Hi friends, my name is Harish. I am working as assistant professor in Electronics and Communication Engineering department. In my previous videos, I have explained about the optical communication subject. In another video, I explained frequently asked questions in the unit 1 of optical communication subject. Today I want to discuss about simple tips which are useful for the students who want to secure pass marks in engineering end semester exams. This video is intended for the slow learner students, especially for slow learner students who want to secure pass marks without keeping backlogs and promote to the next semester. So the title of the video is Tips to Secure Pass Marks in Engineering End Semester Exams. The first tip is gather frequently asked questions from the previous question papers. So the slow learners or the students who want to secure pass marks, due to some reasons they have not attended the semester college well and maintained a good percentage, lost some classes, so they want to pass and promote to the next semester. So that students, for that students, gather frequently asked questions from the previous question papers. First they have to do this. Second one is, you have to arrange them unit wise and make sure each unit consists of at least 5 questions. What you have to do? You have to arrange them, you have arranged the frequently asked questions, what you have gathered, and you have to arrange them unit wise and make sure that each unit consists of at least 5 important questions. Next one is, identify block diagram or named topics and you have to practice them more. If there are any block diagram related questions, if there are any mathematical derivation or expressions related questions or named topics, like for example in the previous class we have discussed, like there is a Snell's law, so it is a named topic. So these are all very important block diagram related questions, like that we have to practice them more. Next one is, practice all mathematical expressions, diagrams, flow charts based questions frequently. So you have to practice all the, if there are any mathematical expressions, so practice number of times. If there are any diagrams, practice number of times. If there are any flow charts, remember them, read them number of times. So those type of questions, practice them very frequently. Next one is, for example, if there are 6 units in our syllabus, read at least 4 unit important questions framed by you. For example, your university in a particular subject is prescribing 6 units, or the syllabus consists of 6 units. At least read 4 units important questions which are framed by you. So you already have gathered the previous question papers, referred previous question papers, you have collected unit wise, you have made them, you have arranged the unit wise. Okay, so for example, out of 6 units, at least prepare 4 units important questions which are framed by you. And finally, in the end exam, try to write at least 5 points. Try to write at least 5 points for each question and see that those questions consist of diagrams or expressions or flow charts. This is important. What you have to do in the end exam? In the end exam, try to write at least 5 points for each question and see that those questions you are attempting in the end exam consists of diagrams, expressions and flow charts. The reason is, when the examiner is scrutinizing your paper, he will divide the marks for diagram as well as write-up. So, since you have already prepared some diagrams or related expressions or flow charts, these type of questions, you attempt or give priority to attempt those questions first. Draw the diagram neatly and write at least 5 points under that, 5 important points which are describing this block diagram or expressions or flow chart. Definitely, if you follow these tips, very simple tips, if you follow these tips, definitely you will pass in the end semester examination. Thank you and all the best.